For the Wing Chun seminar with Sifu Klaus Brandt, we go inside the church hall and come inside, please, and have a nice seminar.
Together, please. Welcome. We are live from Tunbridge Wells, Kent, England. For my German students, just concentrate yourself. This is English. So, Lee, can you help me, please? And I wanted to, at this live stream video, I wanted to explain to you the Qi sound. And Qi sound, like I said in the beginning, is the soul of Wing Chun, but Qi sound was made in very differently in the past years. I could say the past 20 years, actually. I would say the biggest change was in the beginning 90s, end of 80s, and then all of a sudden, because of a lot of misunderstanding, the Qi Sao looked really, really different, and to every group, actually. But the main thing is was just a moving of arms, and they spoke about sensitivity and everything like that. So, but sensitive, I mean, if you're sensitive, stay at home, yeah? It's better you don't train if you're sensitive. So if you want to be a warrior and you want to fight, so it's better to avoid this sensitivity or too much of your sensitivity during a training. We speak about self-defense, warrior training, so sensitivity is actually something you don't need. So we have to speak about stability and patterns and a clear structure of what are we doing. You know, you cannot just train a technique and you ask your instructors what is it for, and he said, or why are we doing this, and he's saying to you, you know, we do this like because we are doing this since years. That's just it. Yeah, there's no explanation. This is nothing. Yeah. So we in the International Academy of Wing Chun, we want to grow up instructors who are able to explain this, because every technique has a sense. Did you ever see these movies online? If someone has just hanging arms and the other one is coming and doing, yeah, some movement. Did you ever see this? And then I ask me always why. If someone is doing some techniques against a guy with hanging arms, he's standing here, he gets beaten up, and the other one is doing some very, very fast techniques. So if I do whatever, five techniques, six techniques, eight techniques with him, the problem is, why did my first technique did not work? Why my first technique did not work? If the first was a zhang or a zhaking or a zhong, or something else, and he's still standing here, that means I had to have to train this first one to not need the second one. If I would need a second one, and the second one even does not work, something is wrong with me. So if you see something on internet and you see someone's doing three or four techniques, you always should go back, slow-mo, look at the first technique and ask yourself, why did this technique does not work? Or the next one, why? Why do we need five techniques? And then we speak about not wasting time. We speak about ending a fight in seconds. But you need 3 seconds to do eight techniques without an effect. So everything has an effect. And this is what we train for. To be and to act effective. Whatever we are doing. So now we come a bit together and you look at me and I explain you the idea of Qi Sao. Come together and let's start. In Qi Sao, we have 3 very important things to do. The one is suppressing. The second is preventing, actually. And the third is defending. Suppressing, preventing, defending. And these 3 things is or are what we train in Qi Sao. This is very, very important to understand. And I will tell you or explain you the idea of Qi Sao. You know, in some groups, I mean, in internet you see this when they just move arms. What does it mean? So it does not start. We are sensitive somehow. No one wants to strike. But on the train station, no one would start and start wiggling your arms and this whatever sometimes looks like really, really speed padding, yeah, each other. And this is not what we need. We need a structure. And this structure is these 3 points. And these 3 points I wanted to explain to you. The first is he wants to prepare a punch, but he does not punch. This is the number one. So he wants to prepare a punch, but he does not punch. So I have time to say, okay, suppressing. I want to suppress this position. So before he strikes, I do my bomb. From this bomb, I open this position to strike. And I explain it to you by showing you a chisel application. This is the easiest chisel application to understand what I actually mean with preparing something. If you just stand like this, boxing situation, and I would do now a taan, the preparation of a punch, and a punch. A taan, a preparation of a punch, and a punch. It looks like this. That's it. A taan, a preparation of a punch, right? And a punch. Or the other side. This is actually it. Taan, prepare, and punch. That's so easy, yeah? He's lifting. That's just it. This is chisel application. Taan, wu, zongke. Taan, wu, zongke. That's it. This is the idea of chisel. Really easy. And one of the coolest applications at all to do this. Just attack someone and do this. Wu, zong, tang, punch. Tang to control one arm. Wu to control one arm. And punch. As soon as I really can control just this arm and he's not moving it to a better angle, I can easily box him. Is he smart enough to change it to another angle? I cannot. And this is suppressing. You understand? This is the beginning of Chi Sab. Now you understand it much better because of the pictures. And I, whatever, 10 or 20 years ago, or 30 years ago, I learned much better as soon as I saw an application. Because I'm an application guy, you know? I like, okay, when I see the application, I rather train it. If I don't understand it or I don't see the sense behind it, I cannot really train. I can't do it, but it's not that good feeling. So this is the first meaning. I want to suppress the first movement. So now, the other one now, my opponent now, knows nothing about Fug. I press him out because of my way to do a Zong Kuen. But I know if he is outside, then I press him outside. He could attack me, however, from the outside. And the outside is always a dangerous side, because the outside, I say always, the outside always wins if you have no idea to prevent or to defend it. Because this is his arm. The source of his arm is his shoulder. And this is just the tip of his arm. The tip is actually not that necessary. The source is much more necessary. So our source of our arm is the same, our shoulder. And now in a parallel idea, his left and my right shoulder. I would be here now, for example. Who has the better position? Of course, me. Because if I go forward, I mean, if I go forward in a good way, not somehow, yeah, and though we have the same possibility, of course, if I do it smart enough, with an outside Zong Kuen or Toi Kuen, whatever it is, and I would say, okay, I stand like this, who has the better position? Of course, me. Because he cannot wedge my arm up to my source, but I can destroy his source up to his arm. As soon as I box him, I lock the power of his source to move his arm, but he can never lock the power of my source to stop my arm. Right? So my position is much better. Outside is better. So what would he think now? Oh, I have the shorter way, I box him. During he would box, I would, even in the last second, I could wedge him. So he would think about his, if he now thinks, he would think first, tongue. If he would do tan now, he would prepare, during he does tan, a wu to strike me, right? Because it would be the easiest thing. So this is a wu position. It's almost like man and wu in our form. And as soon as he's doing a tan, he goes up to prepare the punch. And this is the idea at all. So prevention, moving it outside, control. So, and this is prevention. So pressing, prevention. Of course I know after his hook, or if he is outside, hook or not, he could strike me and he would do it. So if this collides, my idea to prevent and his idea to punch after his hook, then of course our pressure is coming together. So if I would not do this and he would strike me, he would get me because he's outside. You understand? So suppressing, prevention. If this pressure comes together and he pulls out, I have to load up again. You see that? I go back because I know I have to defend because he is outside. You know, I had many, many questions about this because some think if I press outside to this direction, it would be a preparation to get him. But this is just a finished turn, nothing else. If he pulls out, means he prepares a toi kun, rising punch. Does it now mean that this could touch you? I mean, I have no poison at my fingers, you know? What we need is a strike, not a touch. So it's not about who touched first. I'm finished, yeah? Take this. Yeah, that's cool. Of course, I see, wow, he's preparing something. I prepare better, I prepare my defense. If he would not strike, and I've prepared, I could even box, of course. If he wait a bit too long, I would even be able to box, to strike, so I prepare both. But this is not a preparation. This is just an arm, a finished arm, which is actually pressing outside, not forward. And from here, to this, I mean, we all see this is unnecessary. Of course, if I would be here and I would pull out like this, I would allow you to box me. Yeah, I would allow me because I know as soon as I use this punch and I would do it, I destroy his position because I destroy the powerful shot. And this is the meaning of it. So suppressing, preventing, defending. Isn't that easy? It's almost like Danchi, right? For student level program. So, and if we do it together, like here, we can do suppressing. He starts with defending. He is now doing suppressing during I do preventing. Yeah? He is still doing suppressing during I do defending. That's it, actually. And then we repeat it. That's easy, right? And that is Chi Sao. Suppressing, pretending, defending. And then it looks like this. You see, in all these things, it's always a repetition. We always repeat. And try to cut it in parts and think about it separately, then it's much easier to understand the Chi-So. Even for the guys now who train for second or third student level, it's informative, yeah? It's information. But you see, even the guys who are new now today, they see a sense in it, right? You understood what I taught, even if you never did Chi-So, because this is easy to understand. Would you understand something if I would stand with him and would do this? Of course not, because it is nothing. It is because some guys don't want to train, and they taught some other guys who don't want to train. And this is the culture of no training. And then they speak about energy. And I saw even last time a video online. Now they are starting to press into some directions. Yeah. Yeah. They want to press. Maybe they saw a video from me and then try to make something. It's very interesting. Pressing into some direction. First, only wiggling, and then pressing into some direction. You know, if you understand the structure, and our system is absolutely structured from the first student level up to the master degree is a structure. I never tell you something which is destroying what you learned before, right? Never. I always add something, or it helps you even to understand the past better. You can include your new knowledge and rebuild the past, what you did learn some years ago. This is actually a system. But the most important you learn in the beginning, and the most unimportant later. This is very, very interesting, because otherwise, you know, when they look at the movies and they like the Mogensan, this wooden dummy, of course, yeah? I can imagine we would have a lot of wooden dummies here around the corner and everyone would play with the wooden dummy. The wooden dummy is the most unnecessary in this system. And that way we learn it at the last, because it just fills some gaps. The most important is what you learn from the first to fourth student level, really. Because this is what you need at the street. Against a straight punch, low punch, roundhouse, back fist, low kick, straight kick, yeah, someone to grab you or whatever. This is what you learn first four student levels, and then it goes further, fifth student level. Knife defense, against a stick, close fighting ideas, a bit of combat, and then you learn Chisao, some more movements, some more options, possibilities. But not the main thing, it is just to add some, it could happen, but in the most time it is just a straight punch, roundhouse, backwards, always the same. And if you learn for years Wing Chun, you would be surprised that on the street, the most are doing just a punch to your face, want to push you, or it's always the same thing. And that they attack you with somehow some other possibilities, some very, very interesting attack, kick, or whatever, that would be actually a surprise. And this is what happens sometimes during a fight, if someone is defending as well, then it's pretty good, during a fight, but not in the beginning of the fight. For the beginning of the fight, all what you want or have to know is what you learn from the first to fourth student level. Very important. This is it. And if you understand this, you can add, but never forget this, because this is important. This is what you need at the pub, train station, street, yeah, wherever it starts, toilet, yeah, official. Yeah. This is how it always starts. This is, let's say 90%, yeah, 80-90% starts like this. Some are a bit smarter, but not the most. It's always the same idea. You want to smash your... strike your face, kick your body, kick your leg, and it's always the same thing. And then we start with this leg defense ideas, to follow someone, to speak about the main distance, what is main distance, what in what situation I don't have to run forward to attack someone in a defending version. You're not the attacker, you know, someone attacks you, he comes into your track, yeah? You catch him. And later you learn how to, like yesterday, yeah, with Gautzabu, with other football, to make by yourself, to shorten the distance, to go down to main distance and attack the other one, because he don't know how to attack. He wants, but he's standing in front of you. You don't know how, I know how, so I go forward and show him how to do this. Always, in your mind, you want to attack. You are always the attacker. If it is not possible, you have to defend yourself first, before you attack back. But in your mind, you want to attack. You see, Chisao, a very simple idea. Application. If he's doing a bomb, wow, smart, yeah? I cannot do it. So he's preparing the same. I prepare, he prepared. Always the same thing. Tan and Zong Kun, this is the main thing. This is how it starts. And then he wants to prevent my Zong Kun with a bomb. He wants to press me out with a Ta. He wants to prevent my punch from the outside, the first one, with a contact, which we call Fok Sao. Yeah? When we do Fok Sao and you want to go in, I explain it to you later. Not possible. He prepares a Toi Kun. I prepare my Ta, collision, defending. Suppressing, preventing, defending. So easy. Okay, that's our live stream from Trumbridge Wells. See you later, guys.